young.
Castro?
Special Agent Green Big. You interrupted my dinner. What do you gotta say to that?
Mr. Bad Man.
Mr. Tough Guy, huh? Well, when did you become the Prime Minister of Cuba?
I can't tell you until you give me a smoke, man.
I'm not giving you anything before you answer me this question.
Then I am sorry if I cannot help.
Alright, you know what?
You gonna lie?
Maybe I do, maybe I don't. Now. Hey. You wanna play tough? We can play tough. When did you become the Prime Minister of Cuba?
Take it easy, man. February 16, 1959. I was commander of the revolution and I just simply overthrew the court car.
That's what I thought. Well, Mr. Castro, did you ever fail?
Yes. In 1953, when I attacked the Mocada barracks, I was captured and imprisoned, later released. Sent to Mexico. It was on the 26th of July.
So when exactly did you become the president of Cuba?
Well, I led Cuba into a socialist state in December 2nd, 1976. I became the president of the council state as well as the council ministers.
So what was the pay of Biggs? You don't know?
I don't know.
You don't know, eh? You don't know? Maybe that'll make you remember. I'm sorry, Mr. Castro, that was uncalled for. So what was the pay of pigs again?
It was 1,400 CIA-trained operatives, exiles from Cuba, came back and tried to overthrow me, but they did not get so lucky.
And how do you know that it was America that trained them?
Well, there is no evidence since America denies the fact. But national security shows that they thought the people of Cuba would have liked the attack.
Castro, you want to tell me about the missile crisis?
Well, you see, me being good friends with the Soviet Union, I thought it would be a good idea to let the Soviets put their nuclear bombs in Cuba, where they were aimed at the Americans.
Well, I heard they never arrived, Mr. Castro.
You need to take it easy, man.
You know what, Castro? You're not even talking. Maybe I should just... You did not just blow that in my face. I'm gonna staple your lips together if you don't answer this question!
That's funny, man. Go ahead, because now I can't answer any question.
You know what, Mr. Smart Pants? Answer the question. Just answer.
Well, the Americans were going to intercept any missiles coming to Cuba.
And how was this problem resolved, Castro?
Well, the Americans promised to remove the missiles in Turkey and that the Soviet, in exchange, that all the warheads aimed at them would be.
That's a pretty good offer.
Sure.
So, Mr. Castro, why don't you tell me how many times you've been attempted to be assassinated, you know? Because that's a pretty interesting one.
Over 600 times, man.
like I said before, if surviving assassination attempts was an Olympic event, I would win the gold.
I bet you would, Mr. Castro. I bet you would. But I never tried to kill you yet. So you get a voice. So who are your allies, Mr. Castro?
Well, the USSR was like a brother to me, and I also had other allies like Canada and Barbados, Dominican, Sunrise, and I was very good friends with Malcolm X.
And if I were to kill you, Mr. Castro, who would become the president of Cuba next?
My brother, Raul Castro.
Hmm.
The vice president of Cuba.
You know what I always wondered, Castro? How much money do you have?
Well, I have no money. It is all considered the country's money. The Americans say I have $550 million.
That's a lot of money, Mr. Castro.
None of it is mine.
Well, I wouldn't want to hurt a sick guy, because I heard you are sick, Mr. Castro. Is that true?
Do I look sick to you, man? I'm not sick, they keep making things up and say that I have Parkinson's or some kind of cancer.
Isn't it terminal, Mr. Castro? No, Mr. Castro, I wouldn't want to be the one that kills a father, but are you a father?
Yes, I have 6 boys and 1 girl.
That's a lot of Castros if you ask me. Do you believe in God, Mr. Castro?
Well, I don't really want to answer that because if I say no, I disappoint the non-believers. If I say yes, I disappoint the believers. Pope John the 23rd excommunicated me in 1962. He said it was against Christianity to have a communist country.
Thanks, Mr. Castro. You're free to go now.